provocando ya mi palea crónica. Verso dos hombres a los muy bolos. Tú me sanas, luego chaman a tu. Underline it on your Bible, on your own Bible. Des Chroniques, chapitre 7, verset 14.
We are reading from the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 7, verses 14.
So, quito suito, tere na visora como na Yesu.
And when we got it, and we stand up in Jesus' name. Read in Jesus' name. Then if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal their land. Amen.
Amen. Si alors mon peuple, le peuple à qui j'ai donné mon nom, simili et prie. Si les Israélites me recherchent en renonçant à leur mauvaise conduite, moi, dans le ciel, je serai attentif, je pardonnerai leurs péchés et je rétablirai la prospérité de leur pays. Amen.
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 If my people,
who
are called by my name,
go
humble and pray. If the
children
of Israel, they will look for me and they will turn away from sin and their wicked ways, I, God from heaven, I will hear them and I will forgive their sins and I will build
above
of their land.
Amen.
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 Eternal God of glory, merci Zambe pour béni biso sous la carte dans la boue. Dans la boue, béni biso pour tes seigneurs, au niveau de ton biso, na ilo banayo. Yamon a deux au bon terrain, mité manabiso Zambe. Yamba mité manabiso, carte na bo solo. Pour tes Zambe, na comique tsanion sotoye, liboso na yo. Nabiso, mon mot, aucune l'opoté. L'obéra mité manabiso. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Et il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Il y a un peu de temps à faire. Oh yebi, o kanga pe mo beli la yo. Ko luka yo ni la yo tango nyoso. Ya bana nsambe. Lo bela biso na tango yo. No prions nsambe. Nous déclarons ce lieu est un lieu saint. Et si ka bon nsambe na yo fami. Pe paso ma fani ka te sika oyo. To simba mi na sina maboko na yo. O bon bi biso nsambe lo lende so soa ko bomba ka pana na ye. Pe nous prions le sang de Jésus. Et couvrir ndako et tempe le tombe na yo. Mitem na biso sou kwa makati na makila na Yesu. Boy, to Kanisma de Monabiso, Bacomina Lucat in Sika Oyote, Mabazane Comilengela, to Bonne in Zambe, Bobele Roko et Sibiso, et Simba Bebango, Bobele Makilanayo, et Sokolabiso, et Bonisabiso na Bomoko, Bamba Tedo Sabobele, Libota Moko, Boye na Poko Nagelo, Zambe Lobela Motemananga, Lobela Motemananga, Zambe.
Zambe. Oyo ko bima kati na sika oyo. Esa la mouma di toko. E bozo e sika na mouma inanda. Pende ko produit de bons fruits, de fruits mirables et de fruits agréables. Zambe, onyo so go paya, onyo so go keseni, onyo so go konsia molini, onyo so zambe, et ça va simuler tel bozo na kongo na yo, et ça va consulter devant ta parole, et ça va confesser mon aile na yote, et ça va tout salir au mana yote, molim onyo so ambino, molim a go keseni, molim a lolendo la kanda lo kuta, onyo so go konsia satana, kati ne sita oyo, zambe to kuki yango, to pepisi yango, to pikoli yango, what you want to say, comme un n'a comme à Yesu, nous ordonnons au diable de prier les bagages, de dégager, de sortir de cette salle, et nous l'envoyons dans le lieu sérieux, au nom puissant de Jésus. Zambé, nous sommes la paix de côté de Sidaoyo, et qu'on tente la mauvaise comme un yo. Ma bonne monioso, et qu'on boucle ma mauvaise et qu'on soit yo. Pour te quatre en d'accord. Souveraineté, ça ne peut pas. Il y a Jésus Christ. Oh, il y a l'homme à l'Iwa. Oh, il y a l'homme à Kuna. Oh, il y a Nyata Botona Yoka. Oh, il y a un homme à Seko. 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 Oh, il y a un homme à recevoir un biso. Quand il y a un homme à au nom puissant de Jésus. Amen.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Masako le nabiso alelo.
I'm preaching today.
Elobi tozala batna komikitisa.
For us to be humble.
Tomikitisa.
To be humble.
Tozala baeba mikitisi.
To be the people who are humble.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Et Bible zoma nabiso.
And the Bible tells us.
Soki bana nangai to libota nangai.
If my people or my children.
Oyo ngana pesi kombo nangai.
That I have given my name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
To yebi.
We know.
Même na mboka nabiso.
That even in our lands.
Papa pesa kamwana ne kombo.
That the fathers give their children the name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Même sur les singeli que maman fait sa combo.
Even if it is for the mother to name the child.
Akuzwa autorité wana pa ya papa.
They will get that authorization from the father.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Papa aboti mwana ne apesa ka combo ya na ye.
A father that gives birth to his child, they give their name.
E mwana nyoso abemaka kombo ya papa na ye.
And any child that carries their father's name.
Ifo sala na kuyeba wana.
You have to have that knowledge.
Que kombo yo meme esa identité ya papa na yo.
That the name that you're carrying is the identity of your father.
Esa identité ya famille na yo.
Is the identity of your family.
Ifo kumemango. Na simbonyoso na lolendo nyoso.
You have to carry it with all of joy, with all of pride.
Kombo famuna yo foi ba ko defendre ya ko sita nyoso.
The name of your family, you need to be able to defend it everywhere.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tome ba kombo ba moti na biso.
We carry our parents' names.
Oto pesa yango valeur.
So we can give it value.
O biso de tozo mema bendele ya famuna biso pa nyoso.
Because we are the ones who are carrying the flag of our family everywhere.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God is talking about the people that are carrying my name.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Don't see yourself small. Because you are carrying the name of God. When you are called a Christian, you are carrying the name of
God.
When you are called a saint, because you went through the cross, the cross of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God wants you to know that you carry his name, and you need to protect that name, and you need to defend that name. There are some values in that name.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You need to know to defend that name.
Amen.
Because you have the name of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And because God has given you his name, he will never forget you. No matter what the problem, no matter what situation you're going
through,
because he gave you that name, and because you carry his name, he will never forget you. Wherever you will be, God will see you. And you in your life, you have no place to hide from God. There is no way of you hiding from God because you are carrying his name. And because you are carrying God's name, God says, if you humble yourself, if you and I humble ourselves, if you and I humble ourselves and pray, to humble is to break.
Hallelujah.
Amen. To humble yourself is to accept your sin. To accept your sin.
Amen.
To humble is to open yourself up in front of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. To bring yourself into the place that people do not
see.
The secret that you hide that you don't want people to know. But you open it up in front of God. And for God to see deep inside of you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. To humble
is
for you to open your sin in front of God. The God that has given you a name, the God that knows you. And if you add, you also find that he also
knows
you. It means that everything that's inside of you, he knows. That everything that's inside of you, he sees. But when you are humble, even though he knows you, and he knows you, but you come and you open yourself up in front of him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God shows us the vision of David.
Example
of David.
Hallelujah.
Amen. David was a servant of God. God said, I see somebody that has my heart.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Why did God say that David has a heart like him?
But David,
because David was a person that even in the house, where there is no one there, he is by himself. When he sins, when he does something wrong, when he loses his way, if he breaks the laws of God, even though there are no witnesses, even though no one has seen him, but he will come himself and bow down in front of God and say, God, I stole. God. I gossiped. God. I lied.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God. I committed adultery.
Hallelujah.
Amen. No one can see him. And nobody saw him. So there's no one to judge him. But when he comes in front of God, he opens his entire heart. And he shows God where he was lost.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And that's why God has said, this child has a heart like mine.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible says if we humble ourselves and we pray, God says this because he sees that we are too high.
We're too
God sees that we are big.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because we think we are better than everybody. We think we are better than all the other
churches.
This church is better than all the other churches. Our pastor is better than all the other pastors. Our culture is better than all the other cultures. Our eyes are open. Nobody can
come in the middle of us.
We step on all the Africans. In all of Africa, we are more clear than everybody.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We are the people of I. We only see ourselves.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We don't look at anybody else. We don't see anybody else. But when we see them, we see them
underneath.
And when we see them, underneath us. But you will look at our lives are going well. You will look at our countries are not going well. You look at our cultures are not going well. There is hardship in our lives. God has put his promises on you and I. You and I, we are children of promises. We are the descendants of Abraham. We are the children of promises. Many promises of God is over our lives. But we are not reaching. The word of God is not completing in our lives. Because sin is separating us from the promises of God. Sin is stopping the accomplishment of the promises of God over your life.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Sin is opening the doors in your life. It's allowing the enemy to block you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Sin is creating an umbrella over you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And when the umbrella is over you, your prayer will not go through. It's going back down.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 We are not getting
answers
from God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because the sky is hard because of you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The rain of blessings cannot fall. And this is why we are crying. We are a church, but we are crying. We are saints, but we are crying. But the promises of God are many for you and me. But we are not entering them. Because sin sits on us. God that sees sin, he says, my children humble themselves and pray. Many of us pray day and night, but we forget to humble ourselves. Because we think that we have reached. Because we think we have already complete.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But the words of God are not completing in your life. God is saying to us, we who are carrying his
name,
those of us who are his ambassadors, the first thing that God wants from us is for us to humble ourselves and pray. For us to be able to humble ourselves and pray. To be humble, it is also to
fasting. Hallelujah.
Amen. When somebody is fasting, When somebody is fasting, they forget about everything. They forget about your good food. Sometimes you forget about your
perfume.
Sometimes you won't even put your perfume. And sometimes we even forget about our beds.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You are taking away all of that honor. All those things we got it, but we forget about
it.
You have a fridge full of food, but you don't care. Because you want to humble. And we come fasting because we want God to break our
heart.
For God to take you out of your anger. For God to take you out of your stealing.
Hallelujah.
Amen. In front of God, we come naked. So that God can dress us in his white clothes.
Amen.
Amen. When we humble ourselves, we see ourselves as nothing. When we fast, we see ourselves as nothing. We tell God it's not because of food. It's not because of clothes. It's not because of cars. It's not because of phone.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Anything that holds you. Anything that dominates your life. You need to be able to fast against it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So do my phone and be so.
Especially our phones.
Phone call me.
The phone is when somebody wakes up, the first thing is their phone.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And many people, many people are idolizing their phone. I've seen somebody marry their phone.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We married a wedding and a priest also blessed it.
Amen.
Amen. See the level that we are getting to. People are marrying their phone.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Instead, the women they're cheating, but the phone will not cheat on you.
Amen.
Amen. But God says, humble yourself and pray.
Amen.
Amen. To pray is to speak to God. To pray is very important in somebody's life. Because there's only one way that God has prepared, has put for you to talk to Him, and that's through prayer. And prayer, you can pray everywhere. And you can pray in all positions.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God says for us to humble ourselves and to pray.
Amen.
Amen.
And
secondly, God said for us to pray and to ask for forgiveness.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The third is to humble and to pray. In our prayer is first to accept our sin. I used to say it all the time. And I said that if we do not accept our sins, nothing will change. First, we have to accept and acknowledge our sins first. And once we acknowledge that we have sin, then it will help us
to resolve
that sin.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And this is what God is asking us. To humble ourselves and to recognize our sin. When you say to God, I say, God, this my problem is because I'm a thief. You've already entered into the way for God to resolve that situation. Because you know your problem. You know your difficulties. And once you start to accept it in front of God,
hallelujah.
Amen. That's why I always give you that example. If somebody is sick and they don't believe they're sick, they will never go and visit a doctor.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But once you understand that you are sick, then he will give you the strength to stand up and go to the doctor. And once you've already gone to the doctor, it means that you are taking steps for your healing. And once we accept, acknowledge our sins, God is ready to forgive
us.
And secondly, he says to pray to God and ask for forgiveness. We acknowledge our sin in prayer, and also in prayer we ask God to forgive us.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But when we ask for forgiveness,
it's like two ways.
There are two ways. The first way is your problem is you and God. For God to forgive you of your sins. For God to forgive you in your lost way.
But the second way is that you pay only
But the second way is for you also to forgive those who have sinned, who have done you wrong.
Pardon is you are toujours na two ways.
Forgiveness always works both ways.
Amen.
Amen. And they don't separate it.
Amen.
Amen. Even if God forgives you and you do not forgive people, your sins will return because the enemy will accuse you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's why when you are praying for forgiveness of sins, take it in two ways. First of all, is the relationship between you and God. And secondly, is between you and the people that you are around.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And thirdly, God says, to look for me. But to seek for God is for us to seek for Him in truth.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 I'll give you the example. If I have a headache and I go to the doctor and I go to the doctor and I say, doctor, I'm here because I'm sick and my stomach is
hurting.
Because you said your stomach, the doctor will give you the medicine for your stomach. And that medicine for your stomach will not help your headache. Because your true issue is not the stomach, but your head. And that's why it says, when you come to God, when you come to God, when we come to look for the face of God, we have to do it in truth.
Amen.
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 Amen. And fourthly, if we will repent, if we will throw away or renounce, it means that we will have to separate from our sin.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The first thing is to humble and to pray. The secondly is to pray and to ask for forgiveness and to forgive others. And thirdly is to seek the face of God in truth. And then to renounce everything everything, to throw away everything, to separate from sin, to separate from our bad behaviors, to separate from our bad words, and to call out Jesus into our lives.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God is saying, our people, that my people that have my name, humble, pray, seek for my face, and separate from sin.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Peaceful things is God, is what God is asking us.
Dans une exhortation, dans une prédication, et on a poussé. Alléluia.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you complete these four things, God also says He has something to do. And He says, I'm God who sits in the glory of heaven. If you complete all these four things, the first thing is God will hear you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. There are many reasons why God does not hear our prayers.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Don't forget, I tell you all the time, we are not born Christians. We are born sinners. It needs for you to know that you are a sinner. And as you are a sinner, the communication between you and God is broken. And before you can speak to God, that line of communication has to be restored.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And this is where you will come and bring your heart unto God to separate from sin and to call on Jesus unto your life. And once you have done this, God in heaven, first thing He said, He will hear you. If you pray to God and God does not hear you, go back into these four things. Go into these four steps. Then God will hear you.
Amen.
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 Amen. And once God hears you, He said He will forgive your sins.
Hallelujah.
Amen. First He will hear. Secondly, He will forgive your sins. It doesn't count on how much your sins are. It doesn't count how big your sins are. It doesn't count if your sins...
It's dark. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Men zambe,
but God, He will hear you and He will forgive you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 All sins are forgiven.
Hallelujah.
Amen. All sins can be forgiven. But it needs for you to prepare the conditions. Some sins are only forgiven through prayer. Some sins are forgiven through action.
Hallelujah.
Amen. There are some sins even if you pray, God will, it needs some actions to happen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And there are also some sins there that God tells His servants not to pray over that issue. Because even if the servants of God pray over it, God will not listen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And there are also some sins
over the Bishop of Simba to the Saint Esprit, or Zalanina Parano.
That if you touch the Holy Spirit, you will not be forgiven on this earth or the world to come. I'm not in the preaching of sin, but I'm just giving points for us to know.
Alleluia.
Amen. For you to be conscious. Because sometimes we think that we're playing with God. That God is love. If I do it, God will forgive me.
Yeah,
God forgives. But the process of forgiving sin is not all the same. Some sins are forgiven easily. Some sins are forgiven very hard.
Alleluia.
Amen.
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 Donc, Mikebisa Yonanda Otolinga Kosala Masumuke, Anasali Nanga Ponza Bazali Alimisa Kakwaza Boli.
Be warned for those of us who want to sin because God is he forgives because he's full of love.
Alleluia.
Amen. If God has forgiven our sins,
Yamisa Tunzamba Lubi,
thirdly, God says,
Ako rétablir prospérité na yo, Ako.
He will heal your land.
Alleluia.
Amen.
He will bless your land.
He will bless your land.
Alleluia.
Amen. For you, because of your prayer, God heals. God forgives you. But he doesn't just end with you. He also says that he will bring blessings onto your land.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Your land can also be blessed because of you. Your family can also be blessed because of you. Your neighborhood can be blessed because of you. Don't see yourself as small. Remember at the beginning I said we carry God's name. We do not know what God does for us. We do not understand what God has prepared
for us.
God has given us value. Because God sees us big, great. That's why he created us in his image. But because you carry his name,
hallelujah.
Amen. You have to see yourself as important.
Amen.
Amen. In your journey,
through you,
there's blessings for your land. Through you, the blessings of your land. Because you carry the name of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The blessings of the land sit on the believers. Sit on the church. The Bible says, for those who carry my name, the unbelievers do not have
them.
Only you and me and those of us who are
Christians.
That's why I tell you, the blessings of the country come through the church. And that's why if the church is destroyed, there's hardship in the land.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If the church loses its way, there's hardship in the land.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And if you see the countries that are crying and then you see the churches, then you will give me reason. The great countries that God has blessed with many wealth, but they are crying day and night. And if you go into those countries, you will find that the church is sleeping. The church is sleeping.
Satan,
the servants of God have put the enemy at the throne of Jesus. We are wearing the name of God, but we are taking on his glory. In the place where Jesus sits, we have put the enemy there. In the churches where we come to get salvation, instead we put spirits of dirt, of mad, of demons in the church. That's why you find in countries there are so many churches, but the hardship is not ending.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I know what Ronald Bonke said about one
country.
If in this country there are truly prophets, how can something like this happen without them knowing?
Amen.
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 Amen. I will go back shortly. The Bible says, because you carry the name of God, God has asked you for four things. For your country to be blessed. First is for you to humble yourself. Secondly is to pray for forgiveness. Thirdly is to seek God in truth. For us to repent and to stay away from bad sin and bring Jesus into our
life.
If we do these four things, God will do three things. First of all, he will hear you. Secondly, he will forgive our sins. And thirdly, he will bring back the blessings of our land. And that's why I
said,
if our lands are not blessed, and they're going through all these troubles,
is that fault in your
and I? Is you and I's fault. Those of us who are called the church.
Cameraman, can you be so camera?